All right, so as you should be aware, there are currently some LEGO kits in Fortnite, including this one, the Lion Knight's Castle. Now, I absolutely love medieval stuff, and I really want this one, but 2,500 is a bit much. Now, with that said, if you only play LEGO mode, I think this is a fine purchase, but if you're just a casual player, it's likely too expensive. So I'm holding out hope that it's gonna be cheaper in price eventually and not buying it just yet. Now, with that said, there is a new LEGO kit coming out tonight. So tonight's item shop, April 24th, you're going to be able to buy the Anarchy Acres bundle. And I'm going to show it to you early. So Epic Games did gift me this because I am an Epic partner and sometimes they send me stuff to review. Now I have good news because, like I said, in the item shop right now, some of these are way too much. So the Anarchy Acres bundle is only going to be 800 V-Bucks. You get 3 builds and then 24 little items that you can place around. They call those decor items. So again, 800 V-Bucks. Tonight's item shop. So let's take a look at what we have. So the main building is the Anarchy Barn Classic. Check this out. This is going to be amazing because they just had this huge farm update as well where you can actually have animals. It's going to be awesome. And then you've got the Anarchy Barn Deluxe. That's not too shabby. And then the Anarchy Loft Barn. Awesome. So as for the little decor items, we've got the Farmer's Favorites. So this includes a clothesline. You see the clothes are hung up quite nicely. We've got a hay bale right there. We've got a pull cart that's right there. We got a round hay bale, which is this one closest to us. We got the wooden scarecrow back there. A wooden hoist, which is right here. Then we got a dried hay bale stack and a fresh hay bale stack. So I'm assuming those are right there. Dry and fresh. Interesting. So that's the first one. Then it looks like we have the homestead interior. So we've got a dining table. We've got an open back chair. We've got a shaded lamp, a side table, a sideboard, a toolbox, and a washboard. Going old school with that washboard. Holy smokes. And then lastly, we've got the rural hospitality. So we've got a bench, a farm table, a flower trio, a handmade chair, a rocking chair, a rustic chair, a simple chair, and a space heater. I'm gonna assume that that red thing is the space heater? If so, that's a big heater. So that's not too bad. Let's see if I can go into LEGO and actually build these. I have a feeling these are gonna take a long time to build. It takes me forever to build just a simple structure, and these are massive, but I'm gonna try. So here we go. Let's go into my survival map. Oh crap, I'm in the dry valley. No! I forgot I was farming stuff out here. Luckily, I have my plane here so we can fly back to safety. Let me just put my balloons back where they belong so we don't fall over. All right, I gotta figure out how to get back to home base. So I feel like they messed with the graphics. I see like a haziness in the sky. That's kind of weird. Wait, my balloons are all mispositioned as well. I didn't put them that high. What the heck? Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. I guess I'm flying to the country, huh? What the? What is going on? Why is my game all glitchy? Did you see that? I was walking on sunshine there. All right, so here's one of my makeshift bases. So I guess I'll just land right here. Whoa! Yeah, we'll drop down right here. What the? That's not good. Okay, my plane is now stuck in the sky. That's not cool. Okay, so this is one of my level 10 villages. Who's this? Who are you? Brooks? What do you mean, nice to meet me, I guess? Wow, they really did update this. This looks sweet. So I can get 2 more villagers now and then 3 animals. Okay, so let's see what we need to build all these. 13 stages for the barn. 22 stages for the loft barn, and then the biggest one is 25 stages. So you need a lot of planks. You need quite a bit of wood as well. Oh boy, let me see how many planks I got. We'll do the classic barn first. I'll put it right next to my crops. Okay, so the good news is it starts a nice foundation for you right here. So that's not too shabby. But like I said, building it is going to take forever. So if you've never built anything in Lego, basically there's a snap mode. And for me, it's L2. So you just hold that and then spam the build button. And you can gradually go along and complete the build. So it is time consuming for sure. Because then you got to go back out, go to the next part, put that down, go back out, go to the next part. If there's a faster way to do this, someone please let me know in the comments. I just wish there was a way to swap to the next part right away. So right here, I got two of these. I'm going to put that down right here. Why can't I just swap to the next piece? Why do I have to go back into the menu and then click the next piece manually? So again, I'll put this. There's only one of these. Let's see. It goes right there. Now, I can't just go to the next piece, or can I? If there is, someone let me know. It just takes me forever to go back, find the next piece, select it, then find where it's got to go, place them down, then go back, find the next piece, and rinse and repeat. It takes forever. There's got to be a quicker way to do this, right? Okay, so obviously I'll fast forward until the project is complete here. Okay, so this one wasn't bad at all. I absolutely flew through this, and now we're done. Look at that. Not bad at all. That probably took about 3 minutes. So I actually have a barn because I have tons of animals, horses, goats, pigs, anything you can think of I got on my farm. And this is a nice looking barn. Not bad. You can see the window up there. I wonder if you can open and close that. So there's a door on the side here. You've got a window right there. You've got the main slider doors, which actually slide. That's really clean. That's literally how they are in real life. Let's back the horses into there. What's on this side? Okay, good. There's no doors on this side because I just got a little nervous because I put it right next to the crops. So the door's on the other side and there's no back door either. So I like that there's a side door. Very handy. Let's look inside. So it comes with a staircase. So if this was my barn, I would stack all the hay up here. And then there'd be animal stalls right down here. That's what the windows are for, so the horses can hang their heads out. So this is not bad. Not bad at all. So it would take me forever to get all the materials for some of these things. Like I wanted to put round bales and hay bales, but that's something I can do on my own time. So I'll just build all three of the main structures for now, and then maybe I'll do a separate video showing all the little items, but it doesn't look like you can open and close the windows. Let me just double check that one up here. No, you can't even get over to it. Okay, so not too bad. I actually really enjoy this, especially the sliding doors. That's really clean. Okay, we're gonna need a lot more planks though. And to make planks, you simply need wood. So that's not too bad. So I'm gonna crank up the production on these. Okay, so while that's going, I'm gonna have to farm up some wood. If you got a super good pickaxe, by the way, you can destroy big trees in one hit. It's insane. All right, let's start with the next build. So it's going to be the Anarchy Loft Barn. This is just one of my screw-around villages, so it's not like this really matters where I'm going to place it. So let's see. There's a window. This is the backside. That's one of the sides. So this must be the front right here. So I'll just place it right here. Okay, so this one has 22 stages. I'll see how long it takes me to spam this build together. I'm gonna have to collect more materials at some point in the middle of this, though. Two more pieces, one more piece, and we're done. Let's go. Okay, so this is the loft barn. So this is where you would keep all the hay up here. Nice staircase to go up. I don't even have a staircase on mine. I gotta put a ladder up and then climb my butt up here. So, oh man, we're gonna have to build a ramp or something. You can't get in here. Ah! Uneven ground did that. So that technically is a door. And then on this side, you got a window. This is the only opening and closing door right here. And you've got the nice loft up above. So very cool. I think this one's more practical over here and easier to build. But this one is definitely well suited for all your hay and multiple animals. And then we've got the deluxe barn. Holy smokes, I'm gonna need a few more planks for this. Three doors on this side, including a slider. Another slider and another door on that side. Holy smoke. So there's multiple access points to this place. I would personally put it like this. And in fact, that's what I'm going to do. Just like that. So a nice big foundation there to start with. Got one more piece right there and we're done. Let's go. The deluxe barn. All right, let's close these doors. So inside, we've got a grand staircase that goes up. You've got a door right here. That's pretty sweet. And then another slider right here, which is really nice. I would love this barn in real life. This would probably be like a $100,000 barn. Main door right there. Let's take a look up in the loft area. So the loft is a little bit smaller on this one, and it's got a wide open window right here. I'm not sure how practical this would be in real life, but it looks pretty cool. Not bad. So my favorite of these three is probably the first one. It's a mix of everything. Got the small sliding doors, a nice staircase going up, a nice loft area. It's not as spacious and it's not as big, but it doesn't clutter up your entire village. Now remember, there's also the new utility structure you can build, the barn. And this is just a miniature one for your animals to live in. You could put those right nearby if you want. Let's see. Ta-da! And now you can get some animals with the animal treats. All right, let's get an aerial shot here. So it looks pretty good. Again, this is just one of my miniature villages. Basically, I just mess around right here. That's why the buildings are all clustered up and no order or anything like that. But these barns look pretty sweet. And for just 850 V-Bucks, it's definitely the cheapest and best value for your Fortnite Lego kits. Not too shabby. Love the bright red color scheme. Beautiful. So there you go. Let me know in the comments if you think these are worth 850 V-Bucks. Hopefully they lower the price of all the Lego kits to that. So there you go. That's all there is to it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. A like is always appreciated. And don't forget to use my supporter creator code, which is Taperton.